This number is 15 because there's 1 10 and 5 ones. Let's read a couple more. Here is the number 23. There are 2 10s, 10, 20, and 3 ones, 1, 2, 3. So that's the number 23. Let's set and read the number 46. You can tell that this is 46. There's 10, 20, 30, 40, and then there's 5 and 6. So that's the number 46. Here's the number 334. So your students would read 300, 1, 2, 300, 30, 10, 20, 30, and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's the number 334. So practice with setting numbers and having your student read those numbers on the abacus so they can get used to reading the numbers before they start calculating problems. Then the next step would be for them to actually set numbers on the abacus without doing any kind of calculation. So you could give them numbers to set on the abacus. For example, you could give them the number 4. And they could either set the number 4 directly because they know that there are 4 beads, or they can count. I would recommend that you have them count the numbers that you're having them set, simply because that's what you're going to have them do when they start doing their addition and subtraction. So if you have them count the number 4, they would count 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's say you want them to count the set the number 22. You would have them set 10, 20, and 1, 2. Or you could have them set 1, 2, and then the 10, 20. It depends on how well you think they can transfer that knowledge. Let's set the number 147. So you could set 100 in the 100s column, 10, 20, 30, 40 in the 10s column, and 7. You could do the counting method by counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 5, exchange 5, 6, 7. So now your number, your abacus reads 147. There are going to be some sample problems for you to calculate, or you can come up with your own sample problems for your students to be able to practice with setting and reading numbers on the abacus.